Shabbat Shalom, everyone. Good Shabbos. I'm here to discuss the portion of the week, Ki Tavo, which is at the very end of the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 26. All of this is taking place now as we're in the month of Elul. And Elul is the time of preparation of mind and soul and heart before the High Holy Days. And as you can see, we're getting ready for the High Holy Days. The portion we're reading, Ki Tavo, has a lot of meaning for us at this point in time. Moses is about to enter the land. And the portion, Ki Tavo, when you enter, this is what you should expect. Entering the land finally, after 40 years of wandering, is a kind of a gift, almost a kind of compensation that God is giving the Jewish people for all those years of wandering, for the hardship, for the trials, for the challenges. And now we're entering our promised land. And we have entered our promised corner already in 1992, and now we're rebuilding our synagogue from the inside out. We learn in this portion that one of the things one should do when entering the land, the first thing is to offer the first fruits, the bikurim. In other words, to make sure that we thank God for the privilege of entering the new land. And very often we forget to give thanks when things are really going well for us. We may ask God, you know, why is this happening to me? Why are these bad things happening to me? But we also have to pause and give thanks to God for all of the blessings that we encounter. And that's part of this portion too. A lot of blessings and then the curses. Blessings if you follow God's ways, curses if you deviate from those ways. In Ki Tavo, in this portion, there are so many more curses than there are blessings. But in a way, there are more negative commandments than there are positive commandments in the Torah. But the challenge is to have something that appears to you like a curse, a bad thing, and try to find a blessing in it. And conversely, to be very careful that things we consider a blessing, if not guarded and protected, could easily turn into a kind of a curse. So we're really at the very end of Deuteronomy, and the end of Moses' speech, and the end of his advice, and Moses has these very important things to share. Talking about blessings, I and we feel so blessed to be in this synagogue and at this time and with all of you. You're going to enter here, perhaps Shabbat. Our first service here is this Shabbat. And you're going to look around and you're going to see how beautiful it is. And not only beautiful, but accessible. The ramp that we have that leads to the lower bima and the upper bima. The fact that the whole bima is closer to the seating. The fact that we really are gathered together as one worshiping community. But the real beauty of this sanctuary, as beautiful as it is not the physical space, but it's what you bring to it. And that your prayers are from the heart and directed to God. So we create a house of worship. It becomes a house of worship when we enter it and our prayers are sincere and genuine. So may we continue to go from blessing to blessing, from strength to strength. Join us this Friday night. There is a Tat Shabbat, and there's a service at 6, and a dinner, and then a 7:30 service when we're all back here in our sanctuary. You may notice there's only one lectern. There's not a rabbi's lectern, not a cantor's lectern. We're all sharing the same lectern. And since we all get along well and play well together, we're looking forward to sharing this one lecture and celebrating Shabbat with you and celebrating the high holidays with you and sharing all of life's experiences, the blessings and and also when things are not such a blessing. Shabbat Shalom.